at ShadowACS again. Some of you may be familiar with the fact that my least favorite anime of all time is DearS. First of all, I should note that fan service doesn't automatically make an anime bad. In fact, two of my favorites, Sekirei and Familiar of Zero, are totally loaded with it. But those anime are great in spite of the sexual innuendo, not because of it. If an anime doesn't have a really great story and character cast to work off of, having a lot of fan service can totally destroy it. However, I really don't think that was the case with DearS, because there's virtually nothing salvageable about it to begin with. Simply put, this anime physically hurt me. To give you an idea of how bad this is, I'm actually concerned this won't make it on the internet, because I might have to resort to smashing my computer screen before the video is finished. So, how does this travesty begin anyway? A truck is driving across a bridge and it gets into an accident, and some kind of cryogenic freezing capsule falls out, and some sexy pigtailed girl crawls out of it. So yes, the love interest in this anime literally fell from the sky. This is gonna be so realistic. We then get to meet our ungodly forgettable protagonist named Takaya, who's such a dork that he needs about 18 alarm clocks plus his childhood friend to wake him up every morning. By the way, guys, Canon already did that joke. You're not being original. After that, a news program introduces us to what can laughingly be called the plot. And by the way, notice how awkwardly and forced this is written.
This is clearly a very historic moment.
That's right. And not just for Japan, but the entire world. Their visit is...
Can't believe it's been a year already.
After our arrival here on your planet, you, the people of Earth, have given us the name of DearS.
So, yes, this is the plot. A bunch of sexy aliens come to Earth and we name them DearS. And by the way, I like to add that that news clip is one of the worst expositions I've ever seen in my life. First of all, what the hell was the historical event they were reporting? They already made a point that the DearS had come to Earth a full year ago. Second, if humans are the ones who gave the DearS their name, why would the DearS feel the need to go out on national TV and announce that to us? It's like if in Barack Obama's inaugural address, he said, "I'd like to point out that you guys just elected me president." This is sloppy writing at its finest, folks. It's pretty obvious they're just trying to force expositions onto us because the writers cannot figure out a way to integrate it into the actual story. And my biggest gripe with that scene, and a significant problem with the rest of the series for that matter, if aliens come to Earth and don't have a name, why the hell would we call them DearS? That's the stupidest name for an alien race ever! We as a human race have been thinking up cool alien names for decades now. You got the Vulcans from Star Trek, the Xenomorphs from the Alien movies, and I guess Jesus is technically an alien since he came from heaven. And you're telling me that when humanity pooled all its creative resources to name an alien race, the best name we could come up with was DearS? Man, the UN must have been really frickin' baked when they made that decision. So after that, we get a glimpse of Takaya's school life, cause, you know, that's more interesting than aliens.
Wow! This is I Wanna Nibble Sweetly, the new Ray Agata film, isn't it? Oh, Takaya! You're a hero!
Look, just remember, Oiko, I'm gonna be short on cash this month.
Okay, stop in on your way home.
Okay, great, but don't let your folks find out.
Wow, I'm liking this character more and more. Every anime protagonist should traffic porn to his classmates. Well, enough of that. It's time for me to introduce possibly the worst comic relief in all of anime.
Excuse me, Miss Mitsuka?
Yes?
Could you put some clothes on?
My goodness!
See, it's funny because teachers don't often come to class dressed in lingerie. And then I mention it's also the most pathetic and pointless use of fan service I've ever seen. And what's even worse than the fact that the teacher's a complete slut is that she's a recurring character. And every single joke she tells makes me want to rip out my own eyeballs so I don't have to watch this shit anymore. So eventually, Takaya gets done with school, and on his way home, he meets the DearS from the capsule. And of course, she's stark naked. But wait, they have to keep this R-rated so they can sell it to 13-year-olds who haven't discovered hentai yet. So let's make it so that the DearS can now magically defy the laws of physics by putting clothes on out of nowhere. Now, it might seem kinda nitpicky, but this is actually a serious flaw. One of the biggest appeals of the sci-fi genre is not just creating supernatural and futuristic ideas, but explaining how they work. Even though a lot of the machinery and designs and stuff like Star Wars isn't entirely realistic, it's set up to make you believe that it could happen. Now, there have been successful instances of magic and science fiction being combined. Code Geass is an excellent example of this. But there, the world was deliberately set up to give the Geass power a sense of mystery behind it. Like, it's an ability of the gods, and very few people know about it. But here, we're just supposed to accept the fact that no one has a problem with the sudden appearance of these aliens with the ability to defy the laws of physics with magic powers. Whatever. Takiya takes the DearS home, and yes, by the way, DearS is plural and singular. I think it's a translation error or something. And the rest of the first episode is just a bunch of horrible comedy cliches. The girl wants to sleep with the guy, but he's too embarrassed. The guy awkwardly tries to hide the girl he has living in his apartment. Yeah, haven't seen that one yet, except for Bleach, Fate Stay Night, Omomori Himari, Sekirei, and God knows how many other anime. The worst part is, it turns out that joke was totally pointless, because in the next episode, his childhood friend discovers her anyway. By the way, Takiya decides to name the DearS Ren, which is actually a pretty good idea. You know, having their bond strengthened by the fact that he was the one who named her. In Shakugan no Shana, when Yuji gave Shana her name, it was a really touching moment. The difference is, though, that that was a good anime, and they managed to pull that scene off really well. Look at how they handle it in this one.
Right. And you are?
Ren 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 Nagusara Renchia Rurun Ren Nakura.
Okay! Ren! Your name is going to be Ren, okay? That's what I'll call you from now on.
So, basically, I can't pronounce your name, so screw you, I'm changing it. Yeah, can't you just feel the emotion leaping off of the screen here? Actually, there are a lot of emotions I associate with this scene, but acting on them would leave several small children dead. And hey, here's another example of horrible, sloppy screenwriting. Remember how the DearS have the power to create clothes out of nowhere? Well, apparently they can also gain the ability to speak a language just by looking at a few books. Oh yeah, they do this really flashy light show to make it seem all mystical and shit, but that's basically the gist of it. Gee, if I didn't know better, I'd say that was the absolute worst plot device ever crammed into anything. And you know what the sad part is? I haven't actually gotten to the worst part of the anime yet. You see, there's a very important part of this anime's story that turns it from shitty romantic comedy to a freaking sacrilege against the human race. I really hope you're ready for it, because I'm going to play a clip now.
But Takiya is Ren's master now. From now on, Ren will be Takiya's slave.
What?
He is not a guardian. Takiya is now Ren's one and only master.
Okay, I must be going insane here. This anime's horrible, but there's no way they'd seriously try to pass off slavery as a major romantic development.
It's true. Ren will forever be Takiya's slave.
Son of a bitch, what sick, demented freak wrote this? I mean, God, there's horrible blatant fan service, and then there's this. You know what? I'm done. I wanted this review to be longer at first, but forget it. I'm not gonna watch any more of this crap. The video is not worth it. So, can you see why I hate this anime so much? It is horrendous in every sense of the word. The premise is terrible, the comedy is tired and overused, and the only memorable character is Miss Teenage Boob Fantasy here, who is only memorable for all the wrong reasons. With the exception of that Time of the Rapture hentai I reviewed in my Ticket to Damnation series, this is the worst thing I have ever sat through. In fact, you know that comment I made about smashing my computer screen earlier?